Welcome to the 2013 Mayor's Youth Academy Culminating Event. I am Keandria Glenn, your 2012-2013 Future Leaders Council Youth Mayor. I am a recent graduate of the International Baccalaureate Program at Thomas Jefferson High School. And I will proudly attend Hampton University in the fall studying psychology. This is my fourth year as an Academy member. I'm a graduate of the Life Stage program and a two-year veteran of the Work Experience Internship program. Last year, I interned in the governor's office under the supervision of Charles James Sr., and this summer, I interned with the Virginia Department of Transportation under Pamela Coger. From these experiences, I've learned so much about teamwork and positive work ethic in the professional workplace setting. Being in the Mayor's Youth Academy has afforded me many memorable opportunities, such as attending a leadership symposium with the Honorable Colin Powell, visiting our national's capital, interacting with the state and local elected officials, and most importantly, gaining valuable work experience that will set me apart from many of my peers in college. How many college students can say that they've interned not only in a large state agency like VDOT, Virginia Department of Transportation, but also in the governor's office? The Mayor's Youth Academy is more than just a place that youth can find employment. It's a place where youth can be able to begin and pursue their dreams. It is my pleasure to introduce to you our mayor, the Honorable Dwight C. Jones, the person who has made this vision very special and a special opportunity that is available to all of us.
Thank you, Madam Mayor. Well, good evening, everyone, and it is a delight to greet all of you and to tell you how very proud we are of each and every one of you tonight. We want to greet all of our Mayor's Youth Academy partners. We want to greet all of the parents, the facilitators, and the counselors. But most importantly, we want to greet all of the 2013 youth participants in the Mayor's Youth Academy. We want you to know that we are deeply proud of each of you. This is the fourth year of the Mayor's Youth Academy. And we are pleased to have had the opportunity during this administration to turn this dream into a reality. When I became mayor, I wanted to make sure that we did something that empowered young people and gave them the opportunity to have models of success and opportunities to be involved in corporate America and to find the very foundation of their passion as they make their way into the work world. And so we want to congratulate you tonight, and we want to encourage you tonight, and we want to challenge you to dream bigger and to continue to stay focused. I want to particularly thank Kings Dominion, our new partner this year, and Greg, thank you so much for all that you have done here at Kings Dominion. You have been a wonderful partner. And we are grateful for you allowing us to have our culminating event here tonight. Kings Dominion hired 100 MYA participants this year. And together with the partnership between Kings Dominion and GRTC, they provided Richmond City young people with transportation to Doswell and gave them industry-specific job readiness training. So I want you to do something special because these particular sponsors have really stepped up to the plate and gone beyond the call of duty, and we want them to know how much we appreciate it. So I want you to all stand and just give them a round of applause. Kings Dominion and GRTC, let's thank them today. Thank you, Greg. We thank you so much, and it gave us an opportunity to know that there is a 900-seat auditorium on the grounds of Kings Dominion. I had no idea, and so we're pleased to be able to have our closing activity here. Now, this year, my staff screened more than 1,200 applications. That's more than twice the number of applications that we received in previous years. And out of the 1,200 applications, 450 young people were engaged in the Mayor's Youth Academy programs. And so you're special because out of that 1,200 applicant pool, you were chosen. All of you deserve a round of applause for being the cream of the crop. And I have to tell you that I have truly looked forward to this day for the past several years. And today I have the opportunity to see all of you, to see what you have accomplished and the great strides you have made during this summer. I want to take this opportunity to peruse and to see some of the things that you have been able to do and just take great pride in all of the accomplishments that you have been making. And I want you to know that even though you don't know it, I've had my eyes on you and my ears attuned to find out what you're doing. I'm listening to what the employers are saying. And I have to tell you that with this particular class, I am particularly impressed. I applaud each of you for your commitment and dedication to this program. And I want to recognize all of the programs, the Summer Works Initiative, Life Stages. I was with them the other night, Youth Gardeners and the Counselors in Training, and the Summer Work Experience participants. You have all done a magnificent job. The Mayor's Youth Academy launched three new initiatives this year, and I'd like to recognize the following organizations for being great partners with the city and allowing our students to get hands-on experience in the workforce and college. We want to acknowledge J. Sargent Reynolds, the city's Department of Social Services, and Steve Harms is here with me tonight, who is our interim DCAO for Social Services. Stand up, Steve, so we can recognize you. The Allianz Global Training Center and King's Dominion. So let's give them all a round of applause. Now let me say to you young people that you are our future. You are the key to the city's future. And it is my hope that you will continue your training, your education, go off to school. And I'm hoping that many of you will come back to the city of Richmond and make us proud as we try to make Richmond a tier one city and to build a better Richmond. Through all of the hard work that you have done, I'm sure that you've enjoyed the experience and had some fun along the way. But we also want you to know that this is a part of the context that will allow you to be successful in the days and the weeks and in the years to come. And so I want to challenge you to dream big and work hard, and I know that you will succeed in whatever you have the opportunity to do. And so now I want to take a moment to thank all of our sponsors who are with us today. Our sponsors are the people who have made this program possible, and each year when we ask sponsors to take this responsibility, they are more than willing. So I'd like for all of the sponsors, wherever you are, if you would stand, we'd like to give you a round of applause as well. All of the sponsors who are present here today, we'd like for you to stand so we can see you. Come on, let's give them a round of applause. We thank you so much. And we thank you for supporting the Academy, and we hope that you've enjoyed the experience and will join us again next year. Let me take this moment to also thank all of the team facilitators, counselors, and supervisors. I appreciate your hard work and dedication and professionalism in guiding these young people on the road to excellence. And I want to particularly express appreciation and congratulations to Leah Walker, who provided excellent leadership for us this year. So Leah, would you stand? And let's give her a round of applause as well. And so we are counting on you. We are happy that you decided to dedicate this portion of the summer to being a part of the Mayor's Youth Academy. And we hope that this experience will hold you in good stead as you climb every mountain and ford every stream. We are deeply proud of each and every one of you. God bless you, and let's have a good time tonight. All right, whereas on May 3rd, 1975, King's Dominion officially opened as Virginia's first theme park and now features the largest collection of roller coasters on the East Coast with 15 world-class roller coasters, And whereas King's Dominion is a top employer of young people in Central Virginia and hires around 4,000 seasonal associates every year, King's Dominion participated with MYA to provide city young people between the ages of 16 and 19 the opportunity to work at the Doswell, Virginia theme park during the summer. And whereas they selected MYA participants to begin working in the park in March of 2013 during their spring break and on weekends, and whereas MYA youth were able to participate in pre-employment training sessions to be hired by King's Dominion and learn valuable workforce skills to develop them into quality employees, and whereas King Dominion graciously offered to be the host venue for the MYA 2013 culminating event, the MYA youth are able to enjoy the attractions of King's Dominion as a part of the celebration of their summer work. And whereas the Mayor's Youth Academy participation in King's Dominion has given MYA youth a set of skills and training and invaluable opportunity through this different outlet, I now therefore, Dwight C. Jones, Mayor of the City of Richmond, do hereby proclaim the City of Richmond's deep appreciation to King's Dominion on this day, and it is signed by me. And Madam Mayor, I want you to present, you make the presentation.
Mayor's Youth Academy, we thank you.
Thank you.
Good job. Good save.
Good job.
Mr. Mayor,
very good. You want to say something?
Yes, I will. I will say this is a tough act to follow after the mayor and the Madam Mayor. But first, I want to say I need everyone in this audience who's been a participant of MYA this summer of any program, whether it's King's Dominion or somewhere else, to please give yourselves a big round of applause. Taking charge of your future starts now. Coming from the HR industry, I can tell that good work habits start in your younger years, and I am so proud of everyone who's decided that you want to take charge of your future. You want to succeed. You want to make something of yourself, and that is amazing. And you guys took that first step by participating in MYA. And as the mayor said, you guys were up against some tough competition. And you guys were the ones that were selected, and that is amazing. We at King's Dominion are so excited to have participated with the MYA program this year. We're very excited about continuing that relationship next year. But most importantly, we are so honored to have all of the MYA programs and participants and sponsors here with us tonight. I hope you guys have an amazing evening. I am proud of our King's Dominion students. I am so proud of all the MYA students, and I hope you guys go back to school this year and set the example and remember what you learned in all of your programs and set the example for your friends and your partners there in school and share some of the knowledge and why it's important to take charge of your future now when you're young and make a difference. So again, please give yourself a big round of applause. Welcome. We're looking forward to a fun night.
At this time, I'd like to introduce the Life Stage program performers for their wonderful upcoming performance.
She does not know her beauty. She thinks her brown body has no glory. If she could dance naked under palm trees and see her image in the river, there are no palms. in the streets and dishwater gives back no images.
Ladies and gentlemen, welcome to the Life Stage Cafe.
This is a letter to the girl who's been through the same pain as me with troubles and problems and no one to blame. So she blames herself and she hides from men. And this is just how her pain begins. This girl feels like she's going insane, so she tries to prove she's not. She tries to make time stop. She wishes she could press rewind and change her past, but time won't stop, it's moving too fast. So I tell you, girl, you're not alone, and it's okay to be afraid. You can have your sunny life, this is just your time of shade. So keep hope and learn to trust you're not alone. There's me, there's us. I know right now it may be rough, but in the end, it'll make you tough. You're stronger than you think you are. You shine so brightly like a star. But now know it's okay to cry. Know that you may feel bad inside. But one day all of that will die. You'll lose those horrible thoughts as have I. The thoughts of putting it to an end. The thoughts that you can never win. Goodbyes, no tomorrow's the end. El Finn, the thoughts of that man's sin. This is a letter to the girls who is afraid. A letter to the girl who's been betrayed. To the girl who thinks her life is done and believes a victory will never be won. But I beg you, girl, please don't fret because your life's not over yet.
Age 16, long hair, eyes green. Long arms stretched open like limbs on trees, looking for L-O-V-E on the darkest streets. Long legs like the Twin Towers that accent she that accidentally opened up to the wrong P-O-P-L-E. And if you can spell, then keep up with me. See, so just one day out of 365, you attract to the empty sad silhouette that she pretends and tries to be, cause she doesn't know her self-worth, who she is, or what she means. But see, you're still attracted. Like ants to an open feast, she is your open feast, you ugly beast. She gave you access. Age 16, long hair, eyes green. Only 16, but see, she's in love, like she really loves him. Homeboy had her so deep in her thoughts, made her trying to get lost. She had no difference from her outside, from within. Homeboy had her tripping and leaning and limping on that Molly, that Bobby, that Whitney. A young girl raised by the river, he gave her liquor, it ate her liver and her kidney. She said, VC, I loved him, I gave him everything of my existence. And I say, so why did he leave you and then go tell all of his friends what y'all did? And she says, cuz V, see, we're different. I'm only 16, long hair, eyes green. Head full of mysteries with a fist full of dreams. Then see, she got real, real low on her knees. And I was like, girl, what you doing? And she says, shh, God, I know you may not know me, but I would love to know you. And I was like, Stacy, not right now. And she says, shh, God, though I may have sinned, please forgive me. Please forgive me because this is only the beginning. And I'm like, I can't believe she's saying all of this and doing all of this right now in front of me. I mean, what was I supposed to do? I was only 14. See, that was a year ago, but sometimes I still wake up out of my dreams in the morning and feel like I'm still mourning the death of what was my innocent friend. And I feel dedicated to her, so I can't cut her off or leave her lonely. Because I know her life. I know her strife. I know her trifling. And I know her testimony.
People see me as one way, but I see myself as someone who is tired of worrying about what everybody else thinks. Failing, giving up, upset, and mad. So from now on, I am not going to worry about what everybody else thinks. Because their opinion shouldn't be as worth as much as I allow it to be. I love myself because I could be sad, sick, poor, or even dead right now. But God, He has me here for a reason. So I will embrace my positives and even the negatives, because I am the original and only me.
My life is a picture that's already painted. But I'm gonna make it a better picture than the sunset and the dawn. I don't know who to blame, because the people won't change. Everybody always want the glory of fame. But nah, not me. I just want my name.
I'm one of the lucky ones. I have everything I wanted. I have everything I need. I was able to push past the terrors of my past. I am renewed. I am confident. I have my life back. That's all I'll ever need.
There's a light in the darkness. Though the night is black as my skin, there's a light burning bright, showing me the way. But I know
Good evening. I would like to take this opportunity to recognize 5 Life Stage apprentices who were chosen to receive the award because they exemplify excellent leadership while they were in our program. John Quincy Adams said, "If your actions inspire others to dream more, learn more, and become more, you are a leader." And our facilitators and counselors in the Mayor's Youth Academy Life Stage have chosen 5 apprentices that represented a leadership. And I have an acrostic poem that I'm going to read to you, and this is based upon everything that was said about each one of the 5 people that were chosen. L is for leads peers in a positive manner by setting a standard for others to follow. E is for early arrival or staying late. A is for asset, an asset to their peers, facilitators, and counselor. D is for display, good work ethics, and determination. E is for eager to learn by preparing for their task before and during the breaks. E, R is for respectful to facilitators, counselors, and others. S is for serves as a great leader by following instructions and conducts oneself in a professional manner. H is for others, helping others. Their participants perform well by lending their talents and coaching others. The I is for taking the initiative, always taking the initiative, and doing individual tasks and assignments and projects. And the P is for positive attitude. They exemplify a positive attitude no matter who they are around, what is being said to them. They do not allow negativeness to influence them. And I would like to now introduce those five recipients for this award. When I call your name, please come up. We have the culinary track, Justin Rosado. Our dance track is Janisha Bako. Theater track, Vaja Herman. Photography track, Jaya Rosado. And our music vocal track, Kyra Lee. And we are so proud of them and the excellent job that they have done in our Marist Youth Academy Life Stage program.
Life Stage was created in 2001. It was the brainchild of Jerome Scott Smith and myself. We met one day and I explained to him that I really wanted to use the vehicle of theater to be able to get into the minds of our youth so that we could hear their voices. And it has grown from an experiential theater program to a full-fledged academy, highlighting 10 different disciplines, from culinary to dance to instrumental music to vocal music to theater and poetry to fashion,
visual arts,
film and photography would be included in those. We've even done horticulture, ecology, and maintenance.
I like NYA because of the people I get to meet.
I like the NYA because it prepares me for future work experiences.
I like NYA because it has given me the opportunity to learn more about dance and music.
We're grateful to the Department of Parks, Recreation, and Community Facilities within the City of Richmond. And we're also grateful to the Office of the Mayor for having a belief in this program to keep the program funded through the department and the city's general fund. But we always can do more because these kids are here absorbing this information, just like a sponge. And they're giving us creativity in its rawest material, in its rawest form. and we're excited about the energy. And every year is a different year. Every class is a different class. Every experience is a new experience. So whereas one year we may have a highlight of culinary students, another year we may have a highlight of film students. Even though there are 10 tracks, as we call subject matters tracks, that are continuously running throughout the summer, we celebrate each one of them differently. And each one of them has their own discipline. But the thing we like about the program is that we're able to pair a professional and a counselor with a group of 10 kids. And they get to share their craft for a whole summer with a 14 and a 15-year-old. And those kids get to walk away in an apprenticeship-style program with the raw tools that will help to ignite their creativity as they move through life. And it is their life on stage.
I enjoy MYA because it has given me an opportunity to expand my knowledge in film.
I like MYA because it's an opportunity to learn more about what you're interested in.
So we're excited about their life on stage. And oftentimes, through the process of journaling and also through the process of partnering with the Virginia Department of Health and other organizations, we're able to build upon their experience so it becomes a very holistic one. We're able to show them things that they haven't seen before, right here in their own backyard and abroad as well. So we're able to connect the dots in their life when perhaps this time in their life could be very challenging for them, trying to find out who they are and what they have to bring to the world. Many of them have already lived their lives, and many of them have begun to chart their lives through the journaling process that we have here within the Life Stage program. We're also excited about being a part of the Mayor's Youth Academy. We joined the Mayor's Youth Academy about 4 years ago, and we're excited to be a part of the Mayor's vision for the city of Richmond. Is that cool?
Yeah, that's great.
Okay.
Parks, Recreation, and Community Facilities has been doing a counselors in training program since 2003. Since 2003, we have trained over 800 teens to work in our counselors and leaders in training program. Our program is designed for teens ages 14 through 17. It gives them employment opportunities to those who may not otherwise have many options. Chances for teens, it also gives teens a chance to be productive during the summer, to gain firsthand knowledge of career development, learn financial literacy and responsibility, earn money, but most of all, to have fun. Our program is a 9-week program, which is Monday through Friday, and our teens are scheduled to work and assist the staff, the recreational staff, in doing everything in the summer camp program. This year's summer camp theme was Road Trip USA. Our teens went everywhere. We traveled the United States. They were trained in customer service, applications and resumes, arts and craft, dancing for success, dressing for success, first aid, games, money matters, social media, bullying, substance abuse. They also had quizzes, homework assignments, and a final exam. And lastly, everyone had to go through the interview process with the site supervisors to be chosen. Out of 135 applicants, 96 completed the program and are working through the Summer Camp 16 Community Center sites. Please give that and those teens a hand. What has been on the screen is, after we train the kids for 6 weeks, like I said, they're in a 9-week summer camp program. They're instructed in everything, as you can see, field trips, gone fishing, things of that nature. Our program is an excellent program. It's a starter program for ages 14 through 17, who then go on and work in the work experience, and I see some of our kids that have gone through the CIT program that are here tonight. At this time, we have 5 recipients, outstanding teens that we would like to honor, as part of the counselors in training program. And Melanie Ramos will help me with that.
If we can ask the mayor to come up. In addition to what Ms. McGee just shared with you all, the expectations we have for the CITs and the LITs and how successful they were, we asked the center supervisors to send us some nominations for those CITs/LITs that have done an amazing, outstanding, over and beyond job thus far. And we were able to narrow it down to 5 CITs, 1 LIT. And these are the folks that have improved in a commendable way, or they've taken leadership to the next level. They arrive at work with a positive disposition that carries from them to campers, to other CITs, and in some locations, even to the staff that need that extra boost of energy in the morning. So now I'm just gonna call their names. Duquana Kane from Humphrey Calder. And Cameron Johnson from Randolph Community Center. Ramon Baptist from Battery Park. Chelsea Crawford from Bell Mead Community Center. And Sunday Jones from Westover. And now, just to show you that we do have fun.
We are recreators, and we do have fun.
Good evening, MYA. Congratulations to everyone who is a part of this program, whether you are a parent, an employment partner, a student participating in one of our various programs, if you are a counselor who works with the youth or a facilitator, congratulations for the wonderful program that you all have all been a part of this summer of 2013. I have to say that I think that 2013 is the best year yet, and we're only going to get better from here. As a part of our slideshow, you did have the opportunity to see some of the various work experiences that youth who participate in our work experience program are able to have. I have to say that it is quite remarkable to see the accomplishments that youth in the city of Richmond are making as teenagers. It is so inspiring to see the contributions that you all are making to the organizations that you work for. We receive constant positive feedback on a daily basis from our employment partners talking about how impressed they are with you all, how mature you are, how serious you are about your work, and that makes myself proud. It definitely makes the mayor proud. And so I just want you all to know that you have the whole city behind you, and if you continue to dream big and work hard, there's nothing that you cannot accomplish. I do want to just briefly talk about something new that we did this year that we're very proud of. All of our seniors who participated in our program this year were able to take a course as a part of their pre-employment training at J. Sargent Reynolds Community College. They all participated in a career development course where they were able to earn a college credit and design for themselves a career map so that they have a plan in terms of how they're going to reach their goals. And so for all of you who were able to participate in that, congratulations on completing your final class today. The Work Experience Program received several nominations for students who really went above and beyond to show that they were not only committed to their own futures, but also committed to the work that was being asked of them to do. And so I'd like to ask Mayor Jones to come to the stage with me to present our most outstanding MYA participants for 2013 Summer Work Experience Program. Okay, first, Mr. Raheem Smith, who worked for Capital One Unit Boys and Girls Club. His supervisor states that Raheem is without a doubt one of the most impressive young people I've met in 15 years of assisting young people. Raheem has the thought process of a person who knows where he wants to go in life. He is definitive in his disposition as a person, and he stands on strong principles. Congratulations, Raheem. I do want to also say, before I announce the next recipient, that all of these students who were nominated, our office went back and read the case notes from all of the weeks of their work experiences to ensure that they were consistent in terms of the behavior that was expressed to us on their nomination forms. And they also had to have perfect attendance for all of our MYA required events. And so these really are the shining stars of the work experience program. Miss Denisha Jones, Virginia Union University Office of Career Services. I believe this is the second recognition Ms. Jones has received. She was a former CIT participant and received an award in the past. Denisha's employer writes, Denisha is receptive to feedback. She welcomes constructive criticism and demonstrates a willingness to improve, develop, and grow from every experience. She works like a seasoned professional, well beyond her years, and that no doubt has something to do with her previous participant as a CIT. Mr. Luis Camacho. Is Lewis here? Okay. Lewis's employer was the Richmond Ambulance Authority, and they describe him as absolutely the best. The Richmond Ambulance Authority has been a partner of ours since our program began. They indicate that he asks questions, sets a good example, he has a great attention to detail, enjoys learning new things and sharing what he's learned with others, and he is certainly on his way to becoming a successful physician. Miss Unique Harris, Richmond Department of Social Services. Unique's supervisor wrote that her work has been invaluable. She has shared perspective, made observations, provided suggestions that have helped move their office toward in a positive direction. Unique had the opportunity to design an access database that the Department of Social Services will be using to track all of their training records. In addition to designing the database, she also wrote a training manual that is being used by the office now for other employees to learn how to use that database. So certainly impressive work. Our next recipient is Mr. Jalen Woody from the Virginia Museum of Fine Arts. Jalen takes initiative and always knows what needs to be done without having to be asked to do it. His supervisor states that when there is downtime, he comes up with creative ways to keep the campers engaged in learning. Because of these skills, he has been tapped by staff to serve as a mentor to all of their other volunteers. Congratulations. Mr. Kenneth Walker, City of Richmond Department of Planning and Development Review. Kenneth, or Larry, I think as he prefers to be called, is described by his employer as a young man with a willingness to dive into complex projects and produce accurate work. He is always on point and shows a dedication to success. And I believe that Larry is planning and majoring in engineering. Civil engineering, and so his experience in the Department of Planning and Development Review has certainly been one that I'm sure he will find rewarding as he goes on to college. Armani Joyner with the Virginia Department of Aging and Rehabilitative Services. According to Armani's supervisor, she has far exceeded our expectations in both the quantity and quality of her work. Her work ethic and attitude are exceptional, not only for her age, but for any employee. Congratulations, Armani. Miss Nicole Jackson, the Virginia Department of Transportation. According to Nicole's employer, she demonstrates strong leadership skills and a strong work ethic. She is always willing to learn any and everything that is available to her. She is certainly on her way to becoming the type of citizen who inspires others and positively contributes to our society. Congratulations. Mr. Omar Ross with the Allegba Folklore Society. Omar is described as a young person with the ability to discern where initiative is needed. He carries his weight and embraces every experience as a chance to learn. He goes over and beyond the call of duty, and for this, he deserves recognition. Congratulations, Omar. And last but certainly not least, Ms. Brittany Sanderson in the Office of the Mayor. According to her employer, who happens to be standing next to me, Brittany has the right attitude. She is the type of individual that is willing to help others and respect them in the process. She is mature beyond her years and has earned the respect of the entire office, including Mayor Jones. She is certainly a positive force in our community. Congratulations, Brittany.
Thank you.
And so as we do every year, we'd like to take this opportunity as well. Where's my program? Even the director makes mistakes sometimes. As we do every year, for the last 2 years, this is now our second year that we have the honor of joining with Virginia Union University to provide scholarship awards to participants from the Mayor's Youth Academy who will be attending Union in the fall. And so, Mayor Jones, I'm sorry I told you to sit down, but we need you to come back up. And I would like to introduce Ms. Christy Wright, who is the Director of Enrollment Management for Virginia Union University, for the presentation of the Dwight C. Jones Virginia University Scholarships.
Thank you. On behalf of Virginia Union, Dr. Claude G. Perkins, our president, the Board of Trustees, the faculty, staff, alumni, and students, I want to take a moment to say thank you to Ms. Leah Walker, as well as the mayor's office for the invitation. And I want to take a moment to tell you a little bit about Virginia Union. Virginia Union in 2015 will be 150 years old. That's a long time, especially for historically black colleges and universities. We are excited because in our history, we have the product of seven mayors, Mayor Dwight Jones being one of them. So we are always excited to be able to show our alumni. I used to be the alumni director, so I'm always excited to represent the alumni. I am also a product of Virginia Union. We want to take a moment to say to the mayor, thank you for making visions reality. Mayor Jones has been a major part of my life since I went to Virginia Union. So we're excited about the things you do in the community. And at this time, we're going to present some awards. We first have... This award was started by Dr. Claude G. Perkins. And the award is based on recipients that have great performance, such as Mayor Jones. So we have six awards that we're going to present tonight. The first is to Javonna Robinson. It is an $8,000 scholarship, and it's $2,000 per year over a four-year term, and it is considered an incentive grant at Virginia Union University. The next one is the second time that she'll be receiving a scholarship or award tonight, and that is Ms. Brittany Sanderson. She is receiving a presidential scholarship for $54,456. She is also receiving a four-year book award of $4,000. She should have no worries upon entering Virginia Union University. Dream big and work hard. Our third recipient is Tisha Ward. Tisha Ward is receiving $8,000, and that is $2,000 per year. That is considered our incentive grant. Our next recipient is Taisha Hicks, and she is also receiving a $2,000 year, $8,000 incentive grant. Ms. Hicks, are you here? All right. Our next recipient is Ms. Aisha Blackman. She is receiving $5,000, $2,000 per year. which is a VUU merit. Her total scholarship is $20,000. Over a four-year period, that's $5,000 a year. And our last but not least is Ms. Sydney Cunningham. And that is $8,000, which is $2,000 per year. We want to thank everyone for their dedication and with the scholarships from Virginia Union University, and we look forward to seeing you in the fall.
Thank you, Ms. White, and thank you, Virginia Union, for your continued support and partnership of the Mayor's Youth Academy. In addition to providing scholarships to our students, Virginia Union also serves as a host for both interns as well as many of our pre-employment training events that take place. And so thank you again, Virginia Union. At this time, we do want to take a moment to recognize all of our MYA students who have graduated from high school and will be continuing their education. That is certainly a goal of the Academy, and I am very proud to say that out of 50 students who graduated from high school this year who are members of the Mayor's Youth Academy, 43 of them will be pursuing higher education. So congratulations. Ciesha Blackman, Virginia Union University. Alicia Brown, United States Army Military, who will be majoring in biochemistry. Chloe Birch, Virginia Commonwealth University, Chemical Engineering. Poria Burley, Norfolk State University, majoring in biology. Miss Zenobia Cardwell, ODU, majoring in public relations and sports management. Mr. Luis Camacho, Radford University, majoring in biology pre-health. Sydney Cunningham, Virginia Union University, undecided, and that's all right. Miss Keandra Glenn, Hampton University, majoring in psychology. Cameron Hawkins, J. Sergeant Reynolds Community College, majoring in business. Gabriel Hernandez, Virginia State University, majoring in business. Taisha Hicks, Virginia Union University, early childhood education. Jasmine Hicks, Virginia State University, physical health education. Darren Hines, Hampton University, electrical engineering. Joshua Hinton, J. Sergeant Reynolds Community College, business. Gambasola Ibrahim, Brigham Young University in Idaho, majoring in biology. Nicole Jackson, Stanford University, international relations. Sharice Jones, Virginia Union University, bio. Denisha Jones, ODU. Philip Jones, Virginia State University. Khadija Key, Radford University, majoring in athletic training. Archer Malone, Richmond Technical Center, automotive training. Mayola Mayhew, J. Sergeant Reynolds Community College, mathematics and science. Shanice McCormick, James Madison University, majoring in international affairs. Ashley Pleasance, Virginia Commonwealth University, biomedical engineering. Giovanna Robinson, Virginia Union University, majoring in social work. Dominique Ross, Stratford University, majoring in bakery. Brittany Sanderson, Virginia Union University, majoring in the dramatic arts. Ashley Short, James Madison University, majoring in English and International Studies. Deron Spence, Virginia Commonwealth University, majoring in arts. Alexandra Stiff, Howard University. Ayana Tyler, Norfolk State University, majoring in nursing. Kiara Turner, Richard Bland College. Genesis Urena, Brighton Stratton Community College, majoring in nursing. Devin Vaughn, John Tyler Community College, majoring in nursing. Edward Vasquez, Virginia Commonwealth University, Computer Science. Nicholas Vinson, J. Sergeant Reynolds, transferring to Norfolk State, majoring in engineering. And Larry Walker, Old Dominion University, majoring in civil engineering. Tisha Ward, Virginia Union University, majoring in biology pre-med. Jessica Washington, J. Sergeant Reynolds Community College, nursing. Kenyetta White, Norfolk State University, social work. Berkeley Williams, J. Sergeant Reynolds Community College. Sienna Young, University of Richmond, history and English. Congratulations to the class of 2013. Dream big and work hard. And so as we have done since last year, we will be raffling an iPad. This year it's an iPad mini to one of our students who are going off to college to provide them with a technological advantage over their classmates. And so, Youth Mayor, will you please join me on stage to draw our winning name? Gotta shake them up. Okay, reach in. Miss Chloe Birch. Congratulations, Chloe. Congratulations. Congratulations. And Chloe interned at Pfizer this summer and will be majoring in chemical engineering at VCU. So we're very proud of Chloe. Chloe also received a full academic scholarship to Virginia Commonwealth University. So congratulations, Chloe.
At this time, I'd like to thank everyone for coming, and I'd especially like to thank all the Mayor's Youth Academy participants for getting up on those early Saturday mornings, sacrificing their Saturdays to come for the trainings. Give yourselves a round of applause. And I'd just like to encourage all of the 2014 graduates to keep pressing through their senior year and graduate and finish strong. Thank you, guys.
Okay, just one final announcement, MYA, and then we're gonna go and eat and have a nice party. So we want to, of course, extend our gratitude to King's Dominion again for hosting us this year. I also want to thank the mayor for his continued support of this program and always being available to us when we call you. So thank you, Mayor Jones.